St. Francis himself said that true progress quietly and persistently moves along without notice. The same could be said for undergraduate research here at St. Francis University, which has quietly and steadily grown into one of the most exciting parts of student-faculty interaction. These opportunities are perfectly illustrated in the SFU School of Sciences through the work of Professor of Chemistry and Associate Dean, Dr. Balazs Hargitay. Dr. Hargitay regularly mentors promising chemistry students in collaborative research projects, thereby enabling undergrads to get a taste of real-world research. Dr. Hargitay explains how these programs work.
Most of my research students start as freshmen or as sophomores. They are either just taking organic chemistry or will be taking organic chemistry. This project involves some peptide chemistry, but it's still mainly organic chemistry. So either they have just experiencing the classroom of organic chemistry or are getting ready to take organic chemistry next semester. And that's what's exciting about student research in general, is that students can apply the knowledge that they get in the classroom, use the knowledge, realize that what they're learning in the classroom is actually not just in the book, but they can also see it in the labs. The experience that they get in our labs, especially in research labs, serves them really well. When they go to industry, their employers know that if they had the experience in the labs at the university, that training is going to take much less, which economically for the employer is much better.
One of the most recent research opportunities connects St. Francis University students to sea creatures half a world away.
These peptides, these conotoxins that we work with, have been shown to be useful in the treatment of various neurological diseases. More specifically, these are called alpha conotoxins. Alpha conotoxins are one class of conotoxins. They are all made by or found in the venom of cone snails that are found in the Indian or the Pacific Ocean. They sit in the bottom of the ocean. They actually put themselves into the sand in the bottom of the ocean. And they have a little harpoon coming out as a fishing rod. As soon as the snail realizes that the fish bit into the harpoon, it shoots its venom into the fish. Anywhere between 50 to 200 conotoxins. And these are very specific conotoxins in what receptor they bind to. One would make the fish feel really good about itself, one would immobilize it, and one would probably kill it. What's exciting about these conotoxins is that they are very, very specific. So if they are used as drugs, we could eliminate side effects. For example, the alpha conotoxins that we are working with have been shown to be successful in the treatment of various neurological diseases like Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, Tourette syndrome. I want to emphasize that at St. Francis University, we feel that undergraduate research, or in general, student research, is a very important part of the education of our students. It's not just the classroom that a student learns in.
Despite the lessons learned within a formal classroom structure, participation in this kind of collaborative research gives students a unique, hands-on perspective to science. Chemistry interns Stephanie Cirola, Kathleen Fry, and Morgan Dutrow explain what it was like to get involved in real-world research.
The faculty here is very encouraging, and they're willing to work with you if you want to even modify, or if you have a field that really interests you. They'll even let you work around and kind of create a research that is based on something that you're really interested in. And I think that's something that St. Francis has that a lot of other universities don't have.
And then when I came up here again for orientation, Dr. Hargitay was actually sitting at a table. And so I'd remembered him before, so I came up and I said, I'm an incoming freshman and I'm interested in research. How early should I start? He said, as early as you want. Like, you know, next week you can talk to a faculty member, set something up, whatever works. And then he actually talked to me about it because he was working with a few students who were graduating, so he asked if I'd be interested on working research with him.
I think, especially like with OChem, since Dr. Hargitay teaches it and he's my research advisor, like I'll know a little bit more than other kids that may not have had like the research experience, which will be nice.
Participating in undergraduate research outside the classroom can also better prepare students for life beyond St. Francis University. Dr. Charles McVean, Dean of the SFU School of Sciences, explains.
Research at the undergraduate level does several critical things that you can't get from regular classroom instruction. You know, it used to be until some 10, 20 years ago that undergraduate research was reserved for the graduate level. Graduate students do research. Undergrads take classes, do labs, but they essentially learn on a one-way street from their instructors. Undergraduate research greatly changes that. It puts the student in the driver's seat. The student becomes an active part of the whole science process, and that's a tremendously exciting experience. When students graduate from college, we want them to be prepared to deal with the unforeseen and the sorts of situations that were not in a textbook, because that's exactly what they're going to encounter. So research prepares them for that.